Proverbs 18:11 says, "A rich man's wealth is his strong city, and like a high wall in his imagination." Proverbs 18:11. A rich man's wealth to him is like a strong city. As a rich man walks throughout this life, they are able to accomplish anything that they really want with monetary stuff. If a problem occurs and sickness arises, they're able to pay big bucks to be able to get the best doctor or to pay for the fixes that need to be done. If they want the best, they're able to afford the best because they are rich. And so in this life, any struggle or adversity is overcome with the wealth of the rich man. But it is like a high wall in his imagination. In his imagination, he sees his wealth as being the sole source of fixing his problems. And in his imagination, he sees it as a high wall, but in reality, it really is no more than a few inches off the ground, because wealth is good in this life. It can be used appropriately to help other people. It can be used to help us in our current circumstances. But that only is essential if we're looking at this life from the viewpoint of a naturalist or an atheist, that this life is all that there is. There is no eternity. There is no consequences or rewards for what is done in this life. We are not. The atheist believes that there is no salvation, there's no need to be saved, and that nothing exists. And the rich man who is unrepentant and is not born again and is more atheistic in nature and doesn't desire to think on the things of what are to come, he is going to live his life just based upon this life and what he sees and what needs to be done now. And his money, he views it as a strong city, and it is a strong city in this life up to a certain extent, but it's in his imagination where he thinks it's a high wall, but in reality it's only a few inches off the ground, because money does not save the soul. And it is only the Lord Jesus Christ who saves the soul and can bring salvation to the lost and to sinners. We all are sinners. We all are guilty before God. But when we believe Jesus Christ is Lord and Savior, and that he went and died on the cross over 2,000 years ago for our sins because he loved us, and he was resurrected on the third day, and when we believe that, and we believe in him, and we repent of our sins, then we enter into the faith. And it is when we enter into the faith that we are able to see that life is more than money. I mean, there's more than just this life in this space-time realm and atmosphere in which we live in. There is an eternity that is awaiting us, because every soul that is created is immortal. It's going to either live for an eternity in heaven, or it's going to live for an eternity in hell. And we have the libertarian free will to accept or reject Jesus Christ based upon the revelation and the knowledge that God has given us. Because all of us, whether we desire to admit it or not, we all have know that there is an eternity, because Ecclesiastes says God has placed eternity within their hearts. So may we not be as the rich man who went to see Jesus in the Gospels. May we not be as him where we obey everything, we see ourselves as good, but Jesus says, one thing you lack, go and sell all your possessions. Now, it's important to know, riches are not at all bad, and I'm constantly amazed sometimes at how people think money is bad and that being rich is bad in this life, and not rich from God blessing us, and that's all he wants to do is give us riches. That's the prosperity gospel, which is wrong. But I'm talking about the true born-again businessmen that are out there that are providing jobs, and they get income through that, but they're also filtering that income through other sources. It is not at all bad to be rich in this life. And the main message that should come from the gospel story of the rich man is, if the rich man said, "Yes, Lord, I'm willing," I'm sure Christ would have allowed him to keep all his riches and money and wealth, because if he in that instance was willing to give up everything for Christ, then Christ would save him, and then he would have a new heart and a new mind for the things of God, and then he'll see his wealth as more than just what it currently is, but that it can be a form of blessing other people. And that his wealth would not be an idol to him if he was willing to forsake it all and say, yes, Lord, I'm willing to follow you and to forsake all my riches and wealth. But obviously, when riches and wealth, rich men and women in this life, when they're not born again, it's tough for them to enter into the faith because all their problems are solved in this life by money. And so what do they need a savior for? They don't see the need for it because they don't want to acknowledge there's an afterlife. And they're living life of luxury and everything's fine because they have the money to do so. So may we not be as the rich man and be sad about wealth. May we not be as what Proverbs talks about. May we not see our money as a high wall, which is in our imagination. But may we just simply see it, especially when we are born again, as it being a blessing from God and God giving us the responsibility to use that appropriately to help other people. It's okay to buy certain wants or desires as long as that does not overtake the main mission and call of what Christ is calling us to. So it's okay to buy a boat, or if you had a dream car or something all your life and you wanted to get that, let's say you have a net income of $10 million, it's okay to spend, you know, money for that car, but we need to always assess where our heart is at, because if we're just working for those things, that is completely wrong. But if we're working and we're giving a lot of money away, we're helping other people in secret, not desiring to be known by us helping other people, then it's absolutely okay to buy that car that maybe we dreamed of having as a kid. So may we not be as the rich man and see our wealth as a strong city, but may we use our money to help other people, and may we not be diluted in our imagination thinking that our money is a high wall, because it's not. The only high wall and the strong city and the firm foundation and the rock of our faith is the Lord Jesus Christ. And when we believe in him, we repent of our sins, we receive the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit will help guide us to use our money appropriately and to use the talents and gifts that God has given us to further his kingdom here in this life, because we will not allow money to dictate what we do, and it will not become an idol. But as long as we're being led by the Holy Spirit, the money will be a means by which we can help other people and do so in the name of Jesus.